Christ the Lord is risen today.
Hallelujah! He is risen.
Raise your joys and triumphs high.
Hallelujah! He is risen.
Today our sins are forgiven. Today we have power over the grave. Today let all earth and heaven proclaim.
Hallelujah! He is risen. He is risen.
Christ the Lord is risen today, and our world is forever changed. We have gathered together to celebrate the glorious day of our Savior's resurrection, the day he conquered the grave, and raised us to stand with him before the throne of glory. And we rejoice in the promise of God's word, which tells us we know that our old self was crucified with Christ. And just as Christ raised from the dead, we too may live a new life.
The resurrection was the summation of 3 years of redeeming love. Beside a sea, in a crowded village, on a lonely road, time and again, Jesus reached out to us where we are and showed us what we could become. This is the Easter story, the story of transformed lives by the mercy of the cross and the victory of an empty tomb.
It began on the shores of a river, and in the words of a prophet, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." John knew the one that God's people had been waiting for was imminent. "Make straight his path," he cried. "Prepare a way for the Lord."
There came a man sent from heaven, a voice in the wilderness. His name was John.
Jesus would initiate his mission to change the world by first changing the lives of 12 ordinary men. Unsuspecting and unprepared, they were called to leave all they had known and join Jesus as he set out to transform us one life at a time. come, follow me, Jesus cried, and do not be afraid, for I will make you fishers of men. And they left their nets, their boats, they left their homes and families and lives, and they followed him.
Already on the water, the sun begins to wake another day. It's hard work, but it's a living. When you got mouths to feed and debts to pay. A fisherman just like my father before me. Never thought I'd live a different story. When the voice that spoke creation called your name, you know that you will never be the same. And when you hear drop your nets, you do just what he says, and you know. Answer with your life, and you follow. Some call you foolish to walk away from all you've ever known. And when you finally realize the light you held so dear is not your own, you lay it down and trust the one who's leading. And you find yourself surrendering completely. When the voice that spoke creation calls your name, you know that you will never be the same. And when you hear drop your nets, you do just what he says, and you go. You answer with your life, and you follow. When the voice that spoke creation calls your name, you know that you will never be the same. And when you hear drop your nets, you do just what he says, and you go. You answer with your life, and you follow. You follow.
Follow, follow, follow,
follow. Oh, follow.
What began with 12 would soon reach hundreds, then thousands. Follow, he said, and so they did. Yet they were more than followers, more than listeners or witnesses or even disciples. He would eventually tell them, and us, I have called you friends, and you did not choose me, but I chose you.
Jesus did not spend the earthly hours with people of power and position. Instead, he sought the outcast, the ailing, the lost. He spoke kindness to those who had only known hatred. He offered hope to those who lived in despair.
One day at dawn, the Pharisees brought a woman caught in adultery before Jesus. "Teacher," they said, "the law commands us to stone such women. What do you say?"
Jesus turned to face them directly. "If any one of you is without sin, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." And one by one they left until only Jesus and the woman remained.
"Woman," he asked, "where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither will I condemn you," Jesus said. "Go and leave this life of sin."
Healing to the broken, 'cause you know the past. Blessed are those that hunger, that mourn, that are persecuted, for they shall find comfort, and theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
It started at a wedding in Cana, where he took some water and made it wine. He touched and he healed the lepers and opened up blinded eyes.
Divine teaching and miracles will now culminate at the gates of Jerusalem. As Jesus prepared to enter the holy city for the final time, acclamation and cries for deliverance became one. Some hailed him as king, others hoped for a warrior to end Rome's tyranny. The crowds covered the streets with garments and branches, shouting, "Hosanna," meaning literally, "Save us." Blessed is the one coming in the Lord's holy name.
We were promised a Savior. We have waited for years, holding on to the hope through the suffering and tears. We have walked through the silence, in the darkness and fear. Now it seems our Messiah is finally here.
Oh, to sinners, just a carpenter's son. All the Pharisees hate everything you've become. Still the words of the prophets tell us you are the one. Only God here among us could do what you've done.
Week of Jesus' earthly life played out, he steadily walked the road that had been laid out for him since the beginning of time. With each passing day, he still reached out to those he loved. With each passing hour, lives were still changed and transformed.
In an upper room, we received a new covenant of God's grace poured out for us. In a deserted garden, we learned the price Jesus willingly paid for our behalf. And on a long and agonizing road, we watched as Jesus bore the weight of our sins on his back as he walked toward Calvary.
The world must really have felt that all was at an end. In actuality, it was only beginning.
Filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. The Word became flesh, and the light shined among us, his glory revealed.
Called Golgotha, where they crucified him, and the people gathered, watching, mourning. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.
One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. One day they nailed him to die on a tree. Suffering anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is here.
day of the week, the women went to the tomb where they had been laid. They saw the stone had been rolled away. And an angel said, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? Jesus has risen."
Christ is alive now and for eternity. We rejoice in the promise of his word. Oh, glorious day. Come, let's rejoice the Savior together.
Set the earth on its foundation until time were to begin. Who is this King of glory, the Lord strong and mighty?
Omega, the beginning.